Hey, what is up, guys? Your boy Seventh here, back with another video. And today, it's over. It's finally over. Today, we're reviewing Dead Island 2 one last time. Whoops. It fell out. Anyway, reviewing Dead Island 2 one last time. The final expansion came out, Sola. It came out about what? Couple weeks ago. I know I'm kind of late to it again. Sorry, my apologies. But I just finished it last night. And you know what? I'm not going to be all too negative. You know, because the game is still the same since the last time I reviewed it from the House DLC. But it did get a little bit better. Couple new weapons. Especially, I like the weapon you get when you complete the main quest for the Sola expansion, the chainsaw gun. So it cuts down enemies pretty good. So I like that. I do like the new map. You know, I'm gonna start off with the positives. I do like the new map. It's like a festival theme map. Think of Coachella, Rolling Loud, something like that. More on those lines. So gameplay was good. It was semi-decent. What else? One thing negative I do want to talk about. And it's also a positive. There were some new enemy types. I think there were like two new enemy types. One was some type of like blob dude. He could like disappear underneath the ground and reappear. He wasn't really as bad, just annoying. I would say the new, I'm glad there's new variety of enemies, but they were annoying. So it's kind of a good and bad. One of them that was really annoying is the Whipper. So there's a new zombie now called the Whipper, where it takes out its intestines and whips you with it. Now, I kind of find that hilarious and stupid at the same time, but that enemy type is very annoying. But I really dislike that enemy. That was the only enemy type giving me trouble. But other than that, I was just speeding through, killing zombies. The dismemberment is still A1. I'll still give that to Dead Island 2. And yeah, but let's get to the story, because this is one thing I gotta talk about that I don't like at all. Now that this is the final expansion, and Dan Buster Studios said they're gonna be making more content, but I don't think they're gonna do an expansion. They're either gonna start working on Dead Island 3, or the content that we're gonna get is just like small little incremental updates, maybe a new side quest here or there. But I don't think they have the budget for another expansion for this game. Who knows? Who knows? But for so far, the way this story ended off, I think that's it for this game before they move on to the third game. But my gripe with this game and the story, and also the writing is still cringe worthy, very, very cringe. Like, these are not how people talk to each other. Like, this is how people think people would talk to each other in some type of what, 90s sitcom or whatever. Salutation, kids. Ooh, cool. Like, it's cringe shit. So, the story. I played Dead Island 2, and I understand now that they brought the fact that aliens caused the zombie apocalypse, or that aliens, that we're Newman, basically. Our character is Newman, some type of hybrid between human, alien, zombie type of thing. And I just gotta say, the tonal difference between Dead Island 1 and Riptide, the two, is so fucking weird and bizarre. Like, it's strange that they decided to go in this direction. Like, at first, okay, I thought maybe the alien angle would be kind of good, but now it's just that's how they explain things. Like, oh, we're aliens now. This beat can control us. We can turn other people into aliens just by this music tempo. And I was just sitting there wondering, like, what the fuck, bro? What happened to being a grounded virus? What happened? Now all of a sudden it's aliens. Remember, Dead Island 1 and Riptide is canon to this. All of this is canon to each other. So, unless I miss something in Dead Island 1 and Riptide, and please, for the love of God, let me know if I missed something, because I'm pretty damn sure I did not miss any aliens being mentioned in Dead Island 1 or Riptide. But now we're aliens. So I personally, I do not like this story. I don't like where it's heading, because it's gonna get real stupid. Like, I like my zombie games and shows again, I get it. It's zombies. They're not real. And what I'm about to say is kind of stupid. But like, you guys gonna understand what I mean when I explain. I like it grounded. I like an actual explanation for how the dead are coming back to life, whether it be some type of virus or some fucking, I don't know, something that's explainable, not just aliens. I mean, pardon me, I like aliens, I like conspiracies, I like things like that, but like, it just felt so weird coming from Dead Island 1 and Riptide to this, to now that it just being aliens in the story, aka Newman. So that's my only gripe. The story is heading in a weird direction. It is what it is now. I'm not really mad as I was before when this game first came out. I just accept it for what it is. It's still not better than, you know, I'm not even going to say that because then people are just going to get pissed, but it is what it is. To me, Dead Island 2 is still beneath Dead Island 1 and Riptide. That's just my opinion. But this final DLC, it was okay. I might go back and finish up the side quest for that map. Because the map is beautiful. I like the way they designed it. New enemy types, new weapons. So I can't really hate on it. I just dislike the story. But the gameplay is still good, you know. Well, I would say sort of. It's still good. But sometimes zombies be hitting you. Even when you dodge, like the hit detection is very kind of weird. And it's fun to play in co-op because throughout the stream, I had a co-op partner. I just left my lobby on, you know, because the final boss, now that was kind of weird. The final boss where you fight one of the new enemy types, it's called the Urge or whatever. The dude that just disappears in the ground and reappears. You have to defeat him by hitting these mood orbs. These little orange orbs where you kill zombies around it. It's like mood orbs. And then you kill enough zombies, the mood orbs explode, and you use the orbs to destroy the boss. Doing that by yourself, I don't see how that's possible because that difficulty spiked up a lot. I had somebody who was like max level, came in. He had like hella guns. He was just killing everything for me. So I kind of got through that with ease. But if you're playing that by yourself, I know that's going to be kind of hard. Especially with the fucking Whipper, because that enemy is very annoying. They have range like that. The range on the Whipper is insane. I think they need to nerf that just a little because it's kind of overpowered. But if you like a challenge, it is what it is. So overall, it was okay. It was fine. You know, I got my money's worth out of Dead Island 2, two full expansions. All I'm going to say is that this expansion was better than the house expansion. House expansion was kind of boring. This one kind of felt lively, mostly due to the setting because, you know, it was outside. But, hey, it is what it is. It was good. It was decent. Decent, at least, I would say. So, if you guys want to pick it up or you're on the fence about it, hopefully my review helps you with it. I know it's not kind of just detailed review. This is kind of like an on the cuff review because I just literally finished it last night. I'm just giving you my thoughts and, you know, things like that. But overall, I think it was pretty decent. So if you want to try it out, go ahead. It's the final DLC, the final chapter for this game. They did say more content is coming, but who knows what it's gonna be. But yeah, that's my review. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.
Get mad. You say trust God, yelling you should come down from there. You should get down from here.